All right, so I'm gonna make this video to pretty much show you what happens when you overwinter papaya trees. I haven't seen much information on this online, so I thought I'd put a video on this because I've already done this last year. And you know, this is what happens when you overwinter. Overwintering means you bring them indoors, because I do have them in containers. And as you can see, I have them set up this way because I have cats. And if I don't do that, then, you know, basically my floors are going to look like the garden. So I don't want to do that. But all the plants that I have indoors are set up that way. I have cardboard right on top, and I just put the bricks on top. You know, this right here, this is mango. And I've got that set up the exact same way. Avocado. Got another two avocados over here. Got my lemon tree. This gave me lemons this year. I've got my other, this one, these I started, these are 1 year old. I started them from seed. Another citrus tree here. This is grapefruit. This is lemon. And then I've got my another one. This is a mango. I have set up in here like this. Again, I put this like this so that they're little kittens. So I have to protect the plants right now. But the point of this video is that you're going to get these little yellowing leaves like this. I have a video I've already done in the middle of the summer addressing yellowing leaves underneath. Okay, so I'm going to link that video in the description. But this right here, as you can see, look at the way the tree looks now. You have a lot of yellowing leaves, and I just want to let you know in this video that this is actually absolutely normal. When you see things like this happening, just cut them. And you cut them close to the stem, leave a little nodule. And, you know, that little nodule dries out to the point where when you touch it, it just falls out. I mean, I did that even with the yellowing leaves that I had underneath. But what's going to happen is it might get yellow all the way down to the crown, where it's just going to look like a stub. You know what I'm saying? And that's what happened here. This was a stub. And because it was a stub, the trunk got thicker, and then it became a three-stem system coming up. So the fact that that happens here, it might branch out to new growth, new side shoots. Now, you can cut them if you don't want them, if they're going to interfere with any of the other ones that are there. That's the beauty part. You could pretty much cut down the tree however you want. I am expecting fruit for the next year on these, and I love these trees, actually. So that's why I bought them indoors. You know, I have these. This is my two big ones that I've actually did a video on addressing the lower leaves. And then these are this is the other one that I have that I started from seed. This is about, I don't know, I would say like 6 months old. And this is my other one. This one's about 3 months old. But if it goes into dormancy where all the leaves fall out, it's gonna most likely start to create new side shoots. That trunk gets very thick. So yeah, I just wanna let you guys know in this video, this is normal. When you overwinter papaya trees indoors, because you have them in pots, you know, they don't survive frost. They're very, very delicate to even the lightest frost. So, you know, this is normal. Just cut these off. Even if it goes all the way down to the crown, let the crown fall off on its own. The leaves you want to cut off, and just leave it indoors, man. You know, and when it's springtime and you know you're not in danger of frost anymore, bring them back out, and they come right back to life. So it looks like a little greenhouse in here, but next year I am going to build a big greenhouse outside so that I can put them in there, because over here I've got my fern, I've got some of my bamboos, and, you know, the coleus, lemongrass. This is what I basically make my concoctions with, that I pretty much made a video, tea of the gods. And this one I designed, this is my actual abundance setup, where these I actually started from, you know, a cutting. I rooted them out, put them in soil, and then I got my coleus, and then my this right here is ornamental sweet potato with the red leaves in the back. But and then these are pachiras that I started from cutting also. I've got them seeded out with another two citrus trees here. But yeah, that's about it. That was the point of this video. That's normal. Just cut them, and like this video, and if you like it, share, subscribe, and we'll talk soon.